In today's video, I'm going to show you how to transfer your recordings from your ATEM Mini to your computer over a network. It's a quick tip that will speed up your workflow and save you having to mess around plugging in and out hard drives from the back of your ATEM Mini each time you want to transfer files. A little unknown fact about the ATEM Mini is that you can actually access the hard drive connected to it over your network via FTP protocol. And it's really easy to do, and this will work for all ATEM Mini Pro and Extreme models. To get started, you'll need to make sure that you have your ATEM Mini connected to your local network via Ethernet. If you don't know how to do that, I'll put a link to a video where I explain how in the description below, so check that out. Once connected, you need to open up the ATEM Setup utility, click on Settings, and note down the IP address displayed of your ATEM Mini because we'll need that in a second. Now you're going to want to download an FTP client on your computer to easily access your ATEM Mini. Now there's a bunch of them out there. I prefer CyberDuck. It's completely free and it's available for both Mac and PC. So go ahead, get that downloaded and then open it up. In the main window, all you're going to do is press the Open Connection button. And if it's not already selected, choose FTP in the top drop-down box. In the server box, this is where you will enter the IP address of your ATEM Mini. So mine is 192.168.1.150. Then don't worry about the username and password fields. Just be sure to tick the anonymous login option, then click Connect. Once connected, you'll see a window in CyberDuck showing you all of the files stored on the hard drive that you have connected to your ATEM Mini. And from there, you can click and drag the files to your computer as you would do normally. You'll see a transfer window pop up and show you the progress and the transfer speed. And the speeds over a standard 1 gigabit network should be around 80 to 120 megabytes per second, which is plenty enough. Once you've finished transferring all of the files you want, you can just click the disconnect button. And after you've connected once, you can save the connection as a bookmark so that you can quickly access it again from within CyberDuck. Now, one feature I really like within CyberDuck is synchronization. Sometimes you might be filming a bunch of takes on a drive and you might not remember which take you've already transferred to your computer and which ones you still need to do. With synchronization, it takes care of all of that for you and will copy over any new data or change data that is on the ATEM Mini, but not yet on your computer. To set it up, first create a destination folder on your computer that you want the files to sync to. Then in CyberDuck, right-click on the drive folder you want to sync and select Synchronize. Select the folder you just created and be sure that Download is selected at the top. In this mode, CyberDuck will only download the data from your ATEM Mini to your computer. It won't try and upload or alter any of the original files. So even if you delete a file on your computer, the original file will still be on the ATEM Mini hard drive. Click Continue and that will start the sync. Once completed, all you need to do now to sync the folder again and grab any new files is double-click on the sync in the transfer window. It really is that simple, but it will save you a lot of time and effort when it comes to offloading footage from your ATEM Mini, I can promise you that. If you found this video useful, please do give it a thumbs up. That really helps me out with the YouTube algorithms. Also, if you're new here and not yet subscribed, 58% of you who watch my content aren't yet, hit that subscribe button and make sure you turn on the notification bell as well so that you're notified when new videos are released. And if you've got any comments about this video or questions, put them down in the comments below. I take a read of all of those and will reply to as many of those as possible. And if you've got specific questions about your setup, you can always get in contact with me. We can set up a one-to-one consulting session. My email address is on screen for you now. And once you've done all that, guys, I'll see you on the next one.